for joining me for another virtual Junior Ranger activity. I'm Ranger Stephanie. In our previous episode, Ranger Kim discussed a resilient tree that grows here in the high elevations of the park. Do you remember what the name of this tree is? Yes, the Whitebark Pine. As you may recall, she mentioned that Whitebark Pine cones do not open without the assistance of wildfires or Clark's Nutcrackers at Crater Lake. Today, we are going to learn about the Clark's Nutcracker and their relationship with the Whitebark Pine. Clark's Nutcrackers are birds of the mountains. Their range stretches from British Columbia down through the western United States and into New Mexico. The first recorded account of a Clark's Nutcracker was in 1805 during Lewis and Clark's expedition across North America. While in Idaho, Meriwether Lewis captured a Clark's Nutcracker specimen, which he brought back with him upon concluding their trip. The Clark's Nutcracker was one of the three new species discovered during the exploration. They are members of the corvid family with J-sized bodies. One major identifying feature is their long, sharp-tipped beak. They weigh about 5 ounces, which is similar to the weight of a baseball. They are gray birds with black and white wings as well as tails. Their legs, feet, and bills are black. Clark's Nutcrackers are found in mixed conifer forests ranging in elevation zones of about 3,000 feet to 12,000 feet elevation. They spend their time foraging for food and establishing caches. The birds rely heavily on pine seeds as a major source of food. They are also opportunistic feeders, eating insects and small rodents. Here at Crater Lake, Whitebark pine seeds are the major staple of the Clark's Nutcrackers diet. As you may recall, the Whitebark pine cones do not open without the assistance of an animal or wildfire. Luckily, the Clark's Nutcracker has a long, sharp beak that can pry open the cones. The Whitebark pine cones grow towards the top of the tree off high branches. This allows the birds to see the cones during flight. During the summer and fall, Clark's Nutcrackers rush from Whitebark pine to Whitebark pine, hastily prying open the tree's cones. Upon opening the cones, the Clark's Nutcracker pulls out seeds individually. In one study, researchers found that on average, the bird could pull out 32 seeds per minute. Although they may snack on a few seeds, their goal is to cache or hide these seeds for later use. These birds have an expandable pouch behind their tongue, allowing them to transport seeds. Most Clark's Nutcrackers can fit anywhere from 30 to 80 seeds in their throat pouch. That said, one Clark's Nutcracker was observed carrying 150 seeds at one time in their pouch. Can you imagine trying to hold 150 seeds that are about the size of peanuts in your mouth at one time? Clark's Nutcrackers have incredible memories. Once they have a full pouch, it is time for them to hide the seeds. They typically store the seeds in holes in the ground or in tree nooks. They choose to deposit seeds in the ground. They use their beak to dig a hole in the soil. Once the hole is deep enough, they deposit about 3 to 7 seeds from their pouch into the ground. They cover the hole and continue this process over and over again. By November, most Clark's Nutcrackers have cached upwards of 5,000 to about 20,000 seed pods. Later in the month, the trees stop producing cones and the snow begins to fall. It is now time to start retrieving the seeds for food over the winter and spring. When they have their babies in the spring, they return to these previous caches as a food source to feed their offspring. So how do they remember where all these caches are? We will talk about that in a minute, but first, I want to do a little activity. Maybe you have pasta noodles like macaroni or some rice kernels or popcorn kernels. Really, whatever is small and can be used as a caching item will work. Make sure that it's not valuable though, because you might lose it. So I want you here in a second to pause the video and go outside, maybe in your backyard with your adult. Have your adult time you for 1 minute. In this minute, you have to hide or cache your noodles or items of choice. Remember, you want to choose different locations. If a Clark's Nutcracker caches all their seeds in one spot, a squirrel could be watching them while they're caching the seeds. When the Clark's Nutcracker flies away, the squirrel might run over and steal all their food. This would result in the Clark's Nutcracker having no food for the winter. After the time is up, come back in and resume the video. All right, pause the video and get to caching. Whew! Welcome back. I hope that you guys cache some food for later. Do you want to know how the Clark's Nutcracker is able to find their caches? Well, they use a process called triangulation. You know what a triangle is, right? Triangulation is the art of mapping a location by using three points. Once a Clark's Nutcracker digs and deposits their seeds into a hole for cache, they stop and they look around. Scientists believe that they are mapping out the cache. They look for objects such as trees, rocks, and other natural features. They choose three points and connect them in their mind with invisible lines. This creates a map that will help them find their cache when they return to this area. They continue this process at each cache. Scientists have observed them returning to spots and finding their seeds 9 months after they cached them. Their success rate at finding their caches is pretty good, too. Pause the video here in a sec and practice this. Imagine that you're going to hide something at your house. Use triangulation to map out your hiding spot. Draw imaginary lines in your brain connecting three points to help you find your hiding spot. For example, maybe use your TV, and maybe your couch, and maybe a chair. And draw a triangle and think about if you were going to hide something by your chair, how this imaginary line would connect. All right, pause just briefly and come back. Now, what happens if they forget where a cache is? Remember how the whitebark pine cones don't open up without the assistance of an animal or wildfire? Well, if a Clark's Nutcracker forgets a cache, what did they do? They dug a hole in the soil and dropped seeds into the hole, finally covering it up with soil. What do you think might happen? A new tree might grow. So the whitebark pine needs the Clark's Nutcracker, and the Clark's Nutcracker needs the whitebark pine. This type of connection is called a symbiotic relationship. Do you guys hear that? It's like, wah, wah. That's a Clark's Nutcracker. That's so cool. That means he's or she is down in the caldera, and they're likely starting to get ready for the fall. I mean, it's a little cool out here. Want to know something cool? Just like this connection. So look, right behind me, we have a cluster of whitebark pines, and I see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And this looks like one didn't make it, but that would have been another one. But we have at least 6 living whitebark pines behind me. You know what that means? That guy's grandpa, or maybe great-grandpa, long time ago, maybe even great-great-great-grandpa, either way, made a cache right here. And he planted at least 6 or 7 seeds, maybe more. Maybe some of them didn't make it. But we know that at least 6 sprouted, and here today, we have a whitebark pine growing, and this whitebark pine, if you look up towards the top, will start producing cones at some point, which means that that Clark's Nutcracker we hear might come back up here and eat these seeds, caching them, creating this new generation, but his great-grandpa might have been the guy to plant these. How cool is that? Pretty cool. So anyways, let's continue on. Here at Crater Lake, we have whitebark pines that are around 1,000 years old. This means that these little birds have been very busy caching seeds for quite some time. As Ranger Kim mentioned, these trees have been impacted by the mountain pine beetle and blister rust. Luckily, we have teams of researchers who are trying to save and replenish our whitebark pines here in the park. In addition, the Clark's Nutcracker feasts on other types of pine seeds, so they do have some backup options. In fact, some Clark's Nutcrackers travel to lower elevations in the winter, where they can find additional food reservoirs if needed. Clark's Nutcrackers can live up to 17 years in the wild. Can you imagine living at Crater Lake for 17 years? I bet they get some amazing views of Crater Lake as they fly from whitebark pine to whitebark pine. I wonder if individual birds have their own favorite spots to cache seeds. There are a lot of other interesting facts about Clark's Nutcrackers that I could share, but I think it's time for you to go out and see if you can find your previous caches. So, when the video ends, I want you to go back to your original caching spot with your adult. Time yourself for 30 seconds and see how many of your caches you can find. Once time is up, count how many caches you retrieved. Now repeat this whole process, but practice triangulation when you're caching this next time around. It will be interesting to see if you can find more caches with this new tool you've learned. When you're done, don't forget to print out your virtual Junior Ranger badge. Thank you for joining me. We'll see you next time. Bye, junior rangers. It's always fun hanging out. Be well.